Alright guys, how does that look? It says it's up for me. Alright guys, how does that look? Okay. Let me mute myself. Looks good? Okay. Alright, so for those of you just joining us who haven't been able to see the video before, this is Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. This is a turn-based strategy puzzle game, and we are about to do a battle here. We just unlocked the pixies, not the band, the unit. Oh yeah, it's going into the spell meter. Wow, it says it's in 1080p, but that can't be right. Huh. Well, hopefully it doesn't screw up. I didn't really mess with my my connection settings or anything. But people say it looks good, so let's go with it. All right, first thing we need to do is let's make a wall here. And if we move this guy here, we can make an attack formation. And one more turn. Let's move this guy out of the way to set ourselves up. I don't know if this is going to be the most exciting game to watch. I kind of just picked it because Spelunky wasn't working, and this is one of the only games I have installed at the moment that I can actually stream. So, I don't know. It'll get more interesting later on, hopefully. Let's see. Let's move our yellow guy over here, I guess. Form a line there and a line there. And we are victorious. First few battles are going to not be very interesting, of course. Humans are definitely the best in this one. This is Pinful Dwarf. I don't know if I agree. My favorite faction to play multiplayer is the undead. And these are our currencies here. We have gold, minerals, and crystals. And you'll find out what those are for. Oh, linking is just what I explained to you earlier, where you form two attack formations at the same time, and they make each other more powerful. Alright, so we have a little area over here that we can't explore yet. We'll have to come back to that. Oh, by the way, there's no autosave in this game. So if you play this, it'll behoove you to save frequently. There's not really any penalty for dying, but if you have to quit in the middle of a battle or something and you haven't saved in a while, then you might lose some progress. That happened to me once. Yeah, that question mark means related to the main quest. That question mark means a side quest. Main quest, side quest. That's a boss with a little skull. Man, I wanted that treasure chest, but it's going to make me weigh it. I don't know what's wrong with that guy's head. It is all, like, wrapped in bandages. That was supposed to be a nightmare. I don't know if that really came across that well. Finden doesn't believe me. Demons don't exist. Anymore. Take these bears. One of the things that kind of bugs me about this game is that it never really feels like you're, like, commanding an army. Like, the battles don't really feel that epic, you know? It's like you run into a guy and you start fighting, but obviously there's no room for two opposing armies, you know, in this place. So, I don't know. The scale of the battles doesn't really match the scale of the rest of the game. Oh, and we got our first artifact. It gives us plus 25% hit points. Oops. I always do that. I always right click when I mean to bring this up. And this is our leaf plate, which is already equipped. So we have our three basic units now. And basic units are one, well, you can see this little icon here. They take up one space. You have 1x1, 2x1, and 2x2. And 2x2 are the biggest, most badass units you can get. Let's see, well, let me go down this way now. Oh. Yes, Pawful Mail is going to be a normal LP. Since the person who requested it isn't able to watch live. So just to kind of get back into the swing of things, I'm just doing a different game. And that was a bronze colored icon, which means that this is part of the main quest. And yeah, I am starting Pawful Mail completely over. I'm not just going to pick up where I left off. You know, don't want to do things half-assed. Well, let's see. Let's make a wall there. And as you can see, we got an extra move from that. We started with two, and now we have three, since these guys formed. You know how match three games work. But this game does it in a really clever way, I think. Let's see. Chain those two together. Put that there. Make some bears. Make some more bears. That's a pretty good first turn. What other games were requested? Kostya, I think. I might have him mixed up with some other guy. Requested a short dungeon hack LP. Just you know, a short, easy kind of one. And I also got a request for DMC, Devil May Cry. And Undead Lion, which is like an old Genesis game that was never released in the US. I think that's it. If I'm forgetting anything, I apologize. I'll go look it up again later. Let's see. I'll set myself up there, I guess. This game looks a lot different than classic Might and Magic. Yeah. I never played a Might and Magic game before this, so I don't know if it has anything to do with it or not. It might just be a name, since Ubisoft, you know, owns the rights to the name. They figure they might as well use it. Wow. Bears are already level 2. I'm getting a little bit of slowdown, which kind of sucks. I probably should have made the window a little bit smaller. Now, if the game has any resemblance to a Might and Magic series, it's probably the Heroes of Might and Magic series, because from what I understand, that's the kind of the turn-based tactical RPG. But I don't know. Like I said, I never played any Might and Magic game before this one. Alright, we got our first elite unit. I don't need a tutorial. I am pretty good at this game. I guess that's not the actual tutorial. Okay. I mean, I'm not an expert at this game or anything, but like I said, I beat the whole thing in like a week. Like, I became obsessed with this game for a short period of time. Does Chromier not deserve his peace and quiet? Dude, I don't know who the fuck Chromier is. I mean, I guess it's you, but I only know that because the game's telling me that. Whoa, there's a dude in that log. The dude's name is Sinrar. Not to be confused with Winrar. So yeah, the demons are kind of orchestrating this plot to make the elves go to war with the humans. I'm not really sure why. That's something to do with some kind of ritual to summon some kind of evil dark lord or, you know, typical fantasy stuff. It's not really my cup of tea. But the game's fun as hell, so who cares? A Duke cheese at this game. No, just drop. No. I simply played the shit out of it. Gold of rubies and ore. Oh, I guess these are rubies? I think rubies are supposed to be red. So yeah, elite and champion units. Those are the 2x1 and the 2x2. And with these, if they die, or if you right-click to remove them from the battlefield, they don't go back into your resources. You have to actually buy more. If they attack, then they disappear and go back into your resources. Unless they die during the attack. I think most rubies are red, but they can come in any color. You know, I don't know, because isn't a sapphire just the same thing as a ruby? But just with like a different pigmentation or something. I thought I read that somewhere. I don't know. Anyway, let's get some quote unquote rubies. I might not be high enough level to fight these guys yet, but let's try. I just saved a minute ago. Oh yeah. Yeah, I'll be fine. Is there a Necromancer Master Wraith campaign? Well, there is a Necromancer. In fact, the Necromancers aren't really evil in this game. Alright, so this is our first elite unit, the Deer. And all the elite and champion units have some sort of special thing to them. The Deer jump over the first row of walls that your enemy has. And to form an attack formation, you simply put two of the same color behind them, and they're ready to charge up. I don't really like the sprite for the deer, because it looks like they have flies buzzing around them, and it just makes them look dirty, kind of. Now, I could right-click on this deer to remove him and make a formation, but then I just have to buy the deer again. So not generally a good idea to do that. Instead, I'll just make a wall there. Alright. Well, that looks like a good move to me. And let's see, should I start making another wall? Nah, I should be fine. Let's start combining some of these bears. Heroes of Might and Magic 3 is still probably my vote for best PC game of all time. Yeah, I was curious about the other Might and Magic games after I like this one so much, but I'm not really sure which other ones to start with. Usually when you summon reinforcements, they don't drop in a useful layout. Like, you're never going to summon reinforcements and have it form a chain. Like, the game knows not to do that, because that would just be too broken. Well, let's move this guy over here, I guess. I really appreciate that you announce your stream a day in advance. Please continue to do so. Well, I always try to give you a little bit of advance notice. Oh yeah, that deer's gonna mess that guy up. I just killed him in one hit because he was too stupid to put a wall or anything there. Fusion is similar to chaining, except that instead of making two attack formations anywhere, you have to make them one on top of the other. I'm just going ahead and show that off, since it's kind of cool, and you don't really get many chances to do it. Remove the blue unit. Oh. So now when you make another attack formation behind that one, they fuse together and it's twice as strong. Actually, more than twice as strong. A little bit. And it uses the fastest charge time of whichever one of the two is furthest along. And you can also fuse walls together, which you do a lot more often than fusing attack formations. At least I do. And some of the bosses aren't just straightforward battles. A lot of the time there's something special that you have to do. Like with this one, defeat him by finding a way over his impenetrable walls. Which, we have deer that can jump over walls, so that should be pretty easy. Alright. Well, first thing you should do, whenever you have a formation like this, you should always take it. Because it gives you a wall and an attack formation and an extra turn. Which is pretty nice. Let's see. Actually, I think I'll do something similar here. That'll give me an extra turn. And I'll move this deer here. The boss fights in this game drove me nuts. Yeah, they can be pretty tough. The last boss, especially, was kind of a nightmare. But it sure felt good to beat him. The hell. I should charge up some bears. Yeah, and a lot of times the randomness of this game can kind of be an issue. But I never got extremely stuck. And normally those bears would have been able to go through that wall, but this is a special situation. Let's see. You can actually charge, you can link elite units to normal units as well, which is what I'll, damn. I was hoping some more yellow guys would drop. But, oh well. Let's move that over there. Not that it matters, since the deer is the only thing that can make it through anyway. But the other formations can make your deer more powerful. So if I create another yellow formation, those two are linked together, the deer will do a little bit more damage. And if I had another yellow guy, I could drop him there. But it doesn't look like it's going to give it to me. So let's see. Let's create some room to charge up my deer there. Oh, and if the units die before they attack, then that negates the link between the attack formations. This will still be a pretty good amount of damage. Yeah, half his hit points, not bad. So yeah, another one of those should do it. I clicked through the woodcutting mini-boss the first time I played this. I was completely lost. Oh, was that the one where you have to hit the specific... Oh, I remember. Yeah, the guys are trying to cut down the tree, and you have to kill them before they can, or something like that. I don't know. That was 30 hours ago in my previous save, so I'm not 100%... Oh, damn. If I had thought, I could have made another bear formation and linked it with that guy. But, oh well. This deer, like I said, it should do the trick. And there's really not much else I need to do. Oops. Damn, it's really chuggy. I should have made the window smaller. I mean, I don't have the connection speed. It's in like 1280 by 720, but I don't have the connection speed to broadcast in 720 anyway, so wouldn't make any difference on your end. I don't know why it says I'm broadcasting in 1080. That can't be right. Leveled up our fairies, leveled up our bears, leveled up ourselves. Didn't lose any deer. Leveled up our deer. That was a pretty good fight. Got some stuff. Some gold and some minerals. One sec, guys. By the way, how do I sound like my human voice? I feel like I'm having a little bit more trouble talking than I was the other day. Oh yeah. A random scrap of blue cloth, but there's only one thing that could possibly be from. What's the only thing made of blue cloth that it could have come from? I don't know. Some guy's cape? I sound like usual. Good. Glad to hear it. I guess I focus more on that stuff than other people do. Wall units respawn with 1 HP after they are destroyed. So it's either that or plus 25% HP. I think I'll take that. That sounds more useful. Save it real quick. By the way, if anyone wants to do some multiplayer in this game, I'd be cool with that. Maybe not tonight, but some other night. There's an ad when you first come to the page. Yeah, that's why I wanted to go with YouTube, so people wouldn't have to deal with the ads. Just install Adblock, I guess. I think the quality is better here than the YouTube stream, yeah. Well, hopefully YouTube gets their shit together and live streaming gets better soon. I mean, I should have known it would have issues because Google Hangouts are pretty shitty too. this is a bounty hunter, this or the bounty agent. This is where most of your side quests will come from. It's basically, here's some guys you have to kill. Kill them and I'll pay you. Oh, Chromier! That's who that guy was. He's a despicable criminal. Right, let's go on ahead and get all the bounties from this guy. I guess there's only three. Later on, there's much more in every area. People that don't have ad blockers seriously just trolling the rest of the internet. Well, to be honest, I only use adblock in situations where the ads are overly intrusive and annoying. And in my book, an ad in the middle of a goddamn live stream is the very definition of that. You know, I wonder if I'm saving a local copy of this. I don't think I am, because I'm using OBS instead of XSplit. Oh well, I can get the copy from Twitch later on. Oh, I should have checked to see what level this guy is. Chromier, okay, he's only level 3, so we should be able to take him on. Unless he has like level 5 badass units or something. Oh yeah, Super House of Dead Ninjas. I'm sorry, just drop. That's the other donation request. Alright, this is just going to be a straightforward battle. Just kill the other guy. Alright, let's get a little bit of this action. A little bit of this action. See, we made several walls simultaneously and we have 5 turns now. God damn, that's a lot of turns. Okay. Let's charge up these guys. And charge up this guy. And bring out some reinforcements. Where do you get adblock at? Just Google adblock. You have to use Chrome or Firefox, obviously. I don't see why you wouldn't. But you know, I do support content that I enjoy by whitelisting those sites. Because, you know, really that's how a lot of people make money. And I don't want to see that content go away. Duke, do you play the main Heroes of Might and Magic games? Nope. This is the first one I've played. Let's see. Let's charge that guy up. Move him out of the way so I can charge up some fairies. Link it with my deer. And this is going to hurt in a minute. Oh, his druid attack slowed down the charge on my deer. I kind of forgot to consider for that. If you like turn-based strategy, you should try them. Yeah, I'd like to. I'm not really sure which one to start with. Alright, we took a little damage, but it all worked out. Hello, Oblivix. How's it going? And shoutouts to everyone else in the chat room. I'm probably going to stop doing shoutouts for everyone, since I don't want to pressure anyone into thinking that they have to stay or that they have to chat. But if you say hi, I'll say hi back. And quite a few resources from that one. You don't have anything else? Guess not. Okay, well, let's save it up. Heroes of Might and Magic 3 is absolutely the best turn-based strategy ever. Huh, I'll have to try it. That game's gotta be pretty old by this point, isn't it? Like, mid-90s? We can buy some more deer if we want. But I think we're good for the moment. Wow, lots of resources over here. $19.99. Age doesn't mean much in turn-based strategy. Oh yeah, I know. I'm not sure if it would run well on a modern computer. Maybe there's a good old games version of it or something. We have an optional battle and a bounty. What level is this guy? Level 5. Probably not ready to fight him yet. See what this guy has to say, though. I still play Shining Force every once in a while. Shining Force is an amazing game. I just wish that they'd release a version of Shining Force where you don't have to sit through the battle animation every time. It gets a little bit tedious. Why is it 1080 plus? I don't know. My window isn't even 1080. But as long as it's working for everyone, I guess it's fine. Alright, well, I see a pretty good move. Let's go ahead and charge that guy up. Aw. Try to set myself up for a fusion here. Duke has this big ass internet. Not really. In fact, I doubt my connection speed. I mean, I know my connection speed isn't high enough to stream in 1080. Let's see. I should probably set myself up for a link. So not sure if that's going to be possible, but I'll try. No, not going to be able to get it. Let's just do some reinforcements instead. I might be able to pull this off. He's got quite a few units there, but I doubt any of them are going to get a chance to attack. Oh shit. Well, I screwed that one up. Oh well. Shit happens. There's an HD mod for Heroes of Might and Magic 3. Cool. Oh yeah, this deer is going to rot this guy's world. I don't know why I was even bothering trying to link him up. 3 hit points. Excellent. Unfortunately, that means this guy's going to get some attacks in, but shouldn't matter too much. Oh yeah. I haven't done my spell meter yet. Or my hero spell. Everyone's spell is different with Onwinds. It's basically just some arrows. You can take out charging units with them. Or you can just hit them with it directly and kill them. seems more like a puzzle game than a strategy game. I mean, it's a pretty good balance of the two, I think. I mean, it's more a strategy game than Puzzle Quest is, that's for sure. Deer formations jump over all enemy walls instead of just the first one. I think I'll stick with my my wall buff. Alright, this guy's level 5. I'm level 4. I might be able to beat him. It depends on how tough his units are. Who is my favorite hero from Necropolis? I'm not sure what that is. Save scum it. Yeah, these units are level 5, so I think I'll come back and beat this guy later. No penalty for fleeing, unless you're in the middle of a battle. If you're in the middle of a battle and you flee, then you lose resources. But you can see what level the guys are before you fight them, with no penalty. Which, from what I understand, is a change over the DS version. The British? Hurry to the Druid tree. But I want to buy those tree folk. They're pretty badass. Don't forget your unregistered hypercam. I saw a video the other day that was recently uploaded that had the watermark for like hypercam or something on it, and I'm like, dude, it's 2013. You have FFsplit, you have ODS, that ODS can save a local copy of a video, all open source stuff, no watermark. These are quite different than they were when I started LPing. Okay, so now we have druids. Druids, you saw the effect of their attack earlier. They increase the charge time of enemy formations by 2 turns. It's kind of useful. I never really used druids that much, because once I unlocked the more badass units, I preferred using those instead. And we can go over here to buy more druids if we want. We only start with 3. But I think I'll keep what I have for now. If you're that cheap, just pirate it. Well, I mean, you don't have to pirate anymore. FFsplit should do everything you need. I don't think I'm high enough level to beat this guy. Yeah, this guy would decimate me. And by decimate, I mean he will, kill every 10th person of me. So I'll come back to him. There's some really skilled people who play Clash of Heroes online. Yeah, I try to go online and play against random people, and they're all like level 300 and they just do insane things. But I have won some games against like level 60 people, which I was pretty proud of. And, you know, I've lost a few games against people of the same skill level as well. Okay, this should be pretty easy. Not the best starting formation. Should be able to do a couple things. Nothing great though. I can do that, and that, and that. Aw man, he has a fusion thing there. I better not let my deer stay in the way. You don't really see the computer doing fusions that much. I'm kind of surprised. Damn. If this thing was here for another turn, I could do a fusion fairy. Did anyone else have the demo for this game on their phones? Yeah, there's an iOS version of this game as well, which from what I understand isn't that great. Well, let's do one of those, I guess. Try to set myself up for a chain. Damn, those blue guys kind of hurt. Yeah, the game's also on Xbox Live and PlayStation Network. So yeah, it's all over the place. Yeah, I've got this guy's clock pretty well cleaned. Yep, didn't even have to attack. How do you get free games? Well, there are plenty of games free on iOS and Android. I've been playing a free Android game called Pixel Dungeon, which for anyone with an Android device is a really awesome roguelike. Totally free, no ads. The guy's still updating it. There aren't a ton of levels. I think there are 20 levels right now. But what's there is pretty good. There are three characters you can play as. There's a warrior, a rogue, and a mage. I've made it to the last level as the warrior, but not the other two yet. We gotta save the tree, man. Freaking tree huggers. I can only make it to 5 as a rogue. Yeah, the fighter is definitely the best character in Pixel Dungeon. Stop the Griffin Sawman from cutting down the druid tree. So yeah, this is one of those funky battles where you have to do more than just hit the other side. You have to hit these two characters specifically. Well, I have a, oh damn, I thought this druid was lined up with the other guy, but I guess he's not. Okay, well, any other formation that I make, except in these two columns, isn't going to matter, so that's what I will focus on. Alright, I only have 2 moves instead of 3, damn. Oh well. Let's make a wall, make some bears, and let's go ahead and set myself up for formation there. You don't have to hit them simultaneously. Oh yeah, that's right, they move back and forth in this one. Damn. So there's going to be a little bit of an element of luck to this one. But if I remember correctly, they move back and forth in a pretty specific pattern. So this guy should move at the same time my bears go off. I think it's just those two positions as well. I don't know. I could be mistaken. I might lose this deer. Okay, so guy on the left is definitely going to die. And after I take him out, I don't think the guy on the right might stop moving after that. I'm not sure. Well, I can do this, I guess. Kind of a last-ditch effort not to lose my deer. Not that it's tremendously important. I can always just buy another one, but it's the principle of the thing. That's a really small saw for such a huge tree. Yeah, I don't know what they think they're going to be able to do with that. It'll take him 20 freaking years to cut the tree down with us. Especially with only one guy moving it. Two wasted attacks there. That kind of sucks. See what I mean about it never giving you an advantageous drop? It always kind of screws you with it. Hopefully I'll be able to set myself up for a foolproof formation here. So I have both my bases covered. I just have to hope that the timing works out on this. Let's see, he'll be here when my yellow guy is at 1. He'll be here when my yellow guy attacks. And then... Damn. The timing might screw me on this. I'm not sure. Well, if nothing else, I can just charge up my stupid arrows and just hit him with that. Although that kind of feels like cheating. Oh, I think I got him. Yeah. I guess he didn't move when I expected him to. The Empire seems as powerful as usual. Yeah, a lot of people online choose to play as the Empire. But I don't know. I think they're kind of boring. Well, let's see. I have a side quest over to the right. Let's see what that's all about. Or not a side quest, but a side battle. Duke, are you still playing Binding of Isaac? Nope. Platinum God, baby. That's what I did in the significant amount of time I had when I wasn't streaming. Oh, a wise guy, huh? Well, let's see. If I... no, that's not going to work. Well, actually, yeah, I can do this. I can drop that there and then make one of those. Yeah, that's the stuff. And then I can move that there and do one of those. And then... One... I'm not going to be able to charge up my druid. I move him there so I have something to block that knight. I should just buy Half-Life so I can get it out of my to download list. You don't own Half-Life? Have you played it? Because if you haven't played Half-Life, you should really just get Black Mesa. I imagine that's the preferred way to play that game at this point. Although I still like just original vanilla Half-Life a lot. Actually, I played Half-Life Source, which is pretty much the same, just with slightly prettied up graphics. I don't have the CD key. That sucks. I mean, I figure you can get it for like $5 at this point. Damn. No chance of using my, my druids. Oh well, let's just charge them up then. 1, 2, 3. I used to play Day of Defeat competitively as a teen. You mean like, for prizes? Like actual pro competitions? Or you mean you just played a competitive multiplayer? I never saw the appeal in Half-Life. I didn't either at first, but I ended up really loving it. Ooh, I can get some fairy fusion going. Yeah, I was CAL League. Is that good? Top 80 in the country. Wow. I wish I could get good enough at a game to play it competitively. I don't know. It takes a lot of practice. Excuse me. I mean, I'm pretty good at this game, but even if they had competitions, I'm nowhere near good enough. And I mean, you wouldn't think there would be that much to being good at this game, but, you know, looks can be deceiving. I'm probably going to take some damage from these guys on the left, but who cares? I've got this pretty well wrapped up at this point, I think. I used to pro play Guild Wars. Wow. I had no idea that game even had professional play. And those bears pack a wallop. So if anyone has any questions or doesn't understand what's going on, feel free to speak up in the chat room. This game, it doesn't look like it has a lot of depth, but I don't know. It really scratches that itch. The strategy itch. But I mean, I'm not normally a strategy guy, so I don't know, maybe to hardcore strategy game players, this game is simplistic and not deep at all, but I am not that bright, so I really love it. Seems to me that those that play very competitively aren't having that much fun, and isn't that the reason to play games? Yeah, that's a very good point. I don't know if I would want this to be my job. Wait, what does this do? Something about druids. I mean, if I could make my job just dicking around and talking while I play games, that would be pretty cool. Increase the druid ability by 1 for each formation linked with that druid. Yeah, I'm probably never going to use that. Alright, am I good enough to take on Skullbro yet? I don't think so. I'm level 5, but his units are still way better than mine. My dad had enough money that we had a computer with a CD-ROM in 1989. Wow. Was your dad Bill Gates? Or Gil Bates? Bill Gates' alternate universe self? Alright, let's make one of those. Here's what I'd like to do. I'd like to move him there so I can drop that down and make one of those. That seems like a pretty good way to start. This game has nice little sprites. Yeah, they look really good. And the character art is pretty good. There's a lot to like about this game. Excuse me. This is the most I've talked in like 3 months. So, you have to forgive me if I'm not very good at it at the moment. They're pixies, not sprites. Wah, wah, wah. Whoa. Do they call them sprites because they're made out of pixels? Like, pixie sounds kind of like pixel. So they call them sprites? Whoa. Dude. Pinful Dwarf, you just blew my mind. Pixels and sprites. Wow, it makes perfect sense. Or maybe that's just a backwards etymology that I just pulled out of my ass. But still. Alright, I have so much stuff I can do with these yellow guys. I think I'm just going to do that. I have 4 moves. Not enough to do a fusion, unfortunately. Let's see. Man, I'm about to lose a deer over here. I was not even paying attention. Let's see. Put that there. That can go. Meh. I mean, again, it doesn't really matter if I lose a deer, but it's the principle. I'm going to take some damage, but who cares? Barely anything. Duke, I'm surprised no one requested a Lost Vikings 2 from you when you were getting requests. Yeah, I was kind of expecting that. That and Popful Mail. Which, you know, Popful Mail was almost a given. I'm surprised people didn't request a bunch of horrible shit. Because for $25 of money, you could have made me play, I don't know, Dragon Warrior 7 or something. Like a 100-hour game. And I would have been obligated to play the whole thing. You could have made me play I Wanna Be the Guy. Or one of the shitty fan games, if you really wanted to make me suffer. Some people like Dragon Quest VII. I love Dragon Quest VII. It's one of my favorite RPGs. But it took me 120 hours to beat that game. And I really don't want to have to do it all again, talking the whole time, which would have been extremely boring. But, you know, if you really wanted to punish me, you could have done it. Yeah, it's a great game. But yeah, it is extremely long. I can probably take on Skull Brown now. Let's see, what level are my units? 4, 3, 2. Eh. I don't know. I'm getting close. Had I known about the Kickstarter, I would have paid for Landstalker. Yeah, sorry I only posted about it on Twitter and Facebook. I wanted to make a video, but I couldn't really talk before. Like, I think I can't talk now. I really couldn't talk before I had all the dental work done. This guy's name is Uni. Please play I Wanna Be the Guy. Please look at my middle finger. Oh yeah, this is one where this dude's in the middle of the battlefield and you can't hit him. Alright, well, let's go ahead and save again real quick, and then I have to use the restroom, so I will be right back. That's better. You know, one thing I like about streaming this game is that since it's turn-based and pretty slow-paced, it gives me a lot of time to interact with the chat room and to talk about random shit. So if any of you have any questions, you know, now's your chance. God, look at all those yellow guys. I don't know if there's anything interesting I can do with them. I can make a wall here or a wall here. No really neat chains or anything I can do. Oh well. Oh, I know. I can move this guy. Let's move him here and then place that guy there. There we go. Now we're cooking. Anything cool I can do with these bears? Not now, but maybe in a couple turns. Well, no, that wouldn't work. Let's just try to set up my deer. Duke, does DOSBox support online multiplayer? You know, I don't know. Most of those old DOS games didn't even have online multiplayer. They just had like LAN or what's it called? IPX. I imagine that would be kind of a nightmare trying to set that up. Oh, there we go. That's pretty good. The problem with this one is that Uni moves around kind of randomly. It's not easy to predict where he's going to go next. You might be able to LP at co-op. I know I looked into Lost Vikings 2, the PC version, and there was some reason I couldn't do a multiplayer. I forget what the problem was. Maybe the problem has been fixed. Man, I really hope Uni moves. You know what? I'm going to change my tactic and do this druid as far away from that guy as possible. Because I don't want this whole right side of the screen to be a death trap for him. And, of course, he's just going to stay there. Well, hopefully that griffin will be it. Aw. You did that on purpose, didn't you? Whew. That was close. I was a little worried for a second. You stay over there. Don't come over here where all the danger is. Uni moves from one edge to the other, does he? I didn't know that. It didn't look like he had much of a pattern. If it's not flies around the deer, then what is it? I think it's like butterflies. You know, all that hippy dippy druid stuff. Oh, what the hell? Oh yeah, I guess he is kind of moving in that pattern. Oh well, this guy's about to take some serious damage. He was not protecting himself against these guys at all. Oh yeah, and now I can just take him out with the arrows. Pow! Arrowed! Are you planning to have a dedicated day for streaming, or will it be random? Well, it won't be random. I'll always announce it a day or so before. I'll try to do it weekly. Thursdays at 7 are actually pretty good, unless something changes that might be the schedule that I stick with. And of course, I'm going to have to be uploading Popful Mail stuff as well, which that should be starting pretty soon. I hope I'm not paging through this text too fast. It's just that there's a lot of it, and it's not very interesting. So basically, the elves think that the humans are attacking them, and the humans think that the elves are attacking them, all because of some shit that the demons are doing. And we don't know why the demons are doing it yet. Are you going to continue to stream this, or will you be switching to Splunky, since you're using different software now? Well, I couldn't get Splunky working with any of my software. That's why I'm doing this. If people like this, I'll keep doing it. I could play through this game again, and I can do some multiplayer with people to spice things up, if they want to. I would have thought streaming would have replaced LPs by now. Well, for me it pretty much has, but you know, since someone paid money to see Popful Mail, I don't want to do it in a stream that they're not going to be able to be here for. Increases fusion attack power bonus. I don't really fuse enough for that to be useful. Oops. I always do that. Oh crap. Did I unequip my roots? I guess I did. So far the roots are the best thing I have. I don't know. The deer antlers are pretty good, I guess. Leaf blade is pretty good. Still haven't lost any deer or druids. Pretty happy about that. Alright, did I save? Let's save. So yeah, would you guys want to see more of this, or is it boring and slow and turn-based, and you want me to play something else? Yeah, Pothole Mail is going to be recorded and uploaded. It's not going to be 10-minute chunks, but I'll probably break by level, or just I'll take breaks where it makes sense. I won't do like hour-long videos, but I'll try to do it gracefully. It's a bit slow. Well, yeah, it's slow, but you know, so's chess. So are, you know, the greatest tactical games of our time. This is kind of a dark game. I bet this guy's evil. What do you guys want to bet? I've got $5 that says that this guy is no good. You can tell by the way his eyes are flaming and there are flames all around him, and you can't see his face underneath that demonic helmet. What else do you have in your library? Yeah, I have Borderlands 2 installed. I mean, I have a shitload of stuff in my library. It's just this is the only thing I have installed that I could stream very well. His name is Lord Bloodcrown. Of course he's a good guy. Yeah, I forgot about that. Lord Bloodcrown. Possibly the best bad guy name since Dark Death. What was the guy from Zeti Hero Project? Dark Death Evil something? Dark Death Evil Man? Lord Bloodcrown. Oh yeah, dragons. I like dragons. Now, do I equip them now? Yeah, I would rather use dragons than druids. No, I'm good. Thanks, though. Let's see. Let's go ahead and save again, just since I sat through all that text. Still don't think I can take this guy on. See, everything was like 5, wasn't it? I think so. Yeah. And he has unicorns that are level 5. I'll come back to you. This year's been slow for games. Yeah, there hasn't been a lot of new stuff this year that I'm super interested in. I kind of want to play Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon. That game looks pretty cool. Not Far Cry 3, just Blood Dragon. Oh, and Bioshock Infinite. I want to get around to playing that eventually. Challenge Twigleaf. That name's a little on the nose. Oh, I don't know how powerful anything is, so it's worth a shot. Get druids for this battle? I did it without druids before. I can probably do it again. You have two guys that are already charged. I'm going to have to, actually, I might not be able to do this without druids. I forget. But hey, I never shy away from a challenge. That's totally not my motto. Yeah, you can go there. Let's see, let's leave that there. There we go. Triple chain. That's some good stuff. Let's try to get a wall set up over here. Probably not going to do me much good trying. Yeah, I remember. I was not able to do this right away last time. Oh well. I guess I will try to take my lumps. Okay. Well, I'm pretty good on this side. I might be able to actually do this, guys. Kenshi is shaping up to be an improvement on Fallout. Have they improved it since the stream of yours that I watched? Because it didn't look like much of an improvement on anything. Looked pretty crappy, to be honest. Now, the thing about the treants is, after they attack, they leave behind part of themselves, and they keep draining life from you every turn until you... Oops. I don't know why I did that. That didn't do me any good. Yeah, they keep draining life from you until you kill the husk that's been left behind. Okay. Oh, I guess they don't do that in this version. Alright. Well, that went pretty well. My strategy when I play through the game single player used to be I keep one elite unit and one of the big guys. I forget what they're called. Badasses, I call them. But when I started playing multiplayer, I kind of like having both badasses equipped. I don't know. Just the greater chance of making a badass unit, it's worth putting both in the two slots, in my opinion. At least in multiplayer. I don't know how well it'll work out in single player. Who needs those druids? Not me. Oh, hey, it's you. Okay, there are more bounties. He just spreads them out this time instead of giving them all to you at once. Angrod. Grr, my name is Angrod. I'm so angry. You know, I want to try taking on Skullbro. I think I'm good enough to take him on now. Druids are laughable in this game. Yeah, see, my philosophy always was... Oh, this guy's an enemy now. My philosophy is always, You should either be dealing damage to the enemy, or you should be killing one of his charging units. Just slowing them down, I don't know. It doesn't do it for me. Where was that guy in here? Or was this someone else? Skullbro. Yeah, that's him. Let's go ahead and save. And it's almost 9, so after this fight, I think I will call it a night. What do you got? Level 5s and a level 2. I think I should be able to do this. And you're only level 5 compared to my level 6. Is there some kind of random encounters? Yeah, in anywhere like this cave where it has a skull and crossbones symbol, you can get into random battles there. And in some of the other areas, you find random battles elsewhere as well. So let's see, I have a green treant and a yellow dragon. Not in a very good position for either of them. Might be able to charge up this dragon. I'm gonna have to get another yellow guy from somewhere. Damn it, I should have moved my treant over one more space. I wasn't thinking. Oh wait. Oh yeah, I can. Okay. So move that there, and that there. And I should be good on my next turn. And I can start charging up my tree as well. Alright, see you later, Oblivix. Thanks for hanging out. Alright, give it one of those and one of those. Pow! I'm gonna have to do something about this vampire. Aw, man, my dragon's poisoned. This is one of the undead armies. You play as all of these unit types, by the way. The elves, the humans, the undead, the necromancers, and the demons. Alright, let's go ahead and set you up there. I'm probably just gonna have to take my lump from this vampire. There's not going to be a lot I can do about it. Put something in his way, I guess. The room's quite lively considering this is your return stream. Yeah, I'm happy with the turnout. Ouch. Oh yeah. Vampires heal the person commanding them when they attack. I don't think I hit him yet, though. I'm about to hit him, though. Boy, howdy. Let's see. Let's move that there, and set up that guy, and then call out some reinforcements. That vampire's about to toughen up. But it's okay. I have a plan. How many people are watching live, by the way? 19? That's pretty good. Pretty good crowd. Alright. Let's put you there. And then, yeah, there we go. Beef up my dragon a little bit. And let's see. Guess I'll do that. Ooh, I know what I want to start setting up. Let's see. If I put him there and move my fairy over here. Yeah. If I don't kill him this turn with the dragon, next turn is going to be pretty awesome. I don't know. He might have enough stuff there to block my dragon. Have I considered a Super Meat Boy stream? Yeah, I've considered it. I'm not very good at that game, though. Yeah, this dragon won't kill him. But it will. Wow, it didn't even kill the vampire? That's crazy talk. Oh, well. Boom. Oh, I love my job. Bring out some reinforcements, I guess. Ooh. I like the looks of this. Let's put that there. And that there. And... make another wall, I guess. I mean, I've beaten Super Meat Boy, but when I go back and try to do, like, all the Dark World stuff, all the extras, it, it does not work out very well. Oh, I forgot I had my arrows. I should have shot this guy. It can be fun watching you fail at Super Meat Boy. Yeah, but I don't want to fail. I don't like failing. It makes me feel like a failure. But if it's for the good of the stream, I might do it someday, I guess. Oh shit, arrows. Oh yeah, the Emerald Dragon leaves this acid on the field, which does damage to any unit on it. One more move. My tree's probably going to take him out. Oh, when you end your turn without using all your moves, it refills a little bit of your mana as well. So there's a reason to do that. If you don't have a reason to move anything. This tree is going to... Yeah. It's going to do the trick. Pow, 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 pow. And as you can see, the tree's still there with 26 hit points. And it would do a little bit of damage every turn until they killed what's left of the tree. Do you ever do blind streams? Yeah, sometimes. It's worked out before, but it also sometimes doesn't work out that well. Alright, all kinds of awesome resources. Completed a bounty. Let's go get my reward, and then I will call it a night. Felt like it's been a pretty good stream. I mean, I am woefully out of practice, but, I mean, not in this game, but just in streaming and trying to be entertaining. But I think it went pretty well. So yeah, this has been Might and Magic Clash of Heroes. Sorry, the YouTube thing didn't really work out that well. Hey, it was worth a shot. And if YouTube manages to get their shit together, then it might be worth exploring in the future. Limbo was one of your best streams. Yeah, but that wasn't blind. I'd already beaten it. But yeah, that was an enjoyable stream. Alright, so let me know what you think. I can play some more of this. I'd love to play some multiplayer on stream. Me and Just Drop and Morse Draconis played a little bit on his stream, but nobody showed up for that. Plus, I wasn't able to talk. But they were talking, so you guys still should have come to watch. But, yeah. If anyone else is interested in doing multiplayer in this game, let me know. Of course, the downside is, what I'd really love to do is like a King of the Hill kind of thing, where like I play against someone and then whoever wins that match plays someone else, but there's no like spectate mode or anything, so I would be the only one. I would have to play in every game, which would be kind of a bummer. But yeah, it's something to consider in the future, I guess. So yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks to all you who donated. Just Drop, sorry I forgot about Super House of Dead Ninjas. That should be fun. Look out for Potful Mill videos coming soon, and I will see all you guys later.